Good morning. Okay, sound check, sound check. Okay. Close your eyes and just start to tune out all of the noise around you, whether you're practicing inside or outside. Let it all go. Yes, thank you. And make a promise to yourself that the next hour is for you and you alone. While you're on your mat, your little harbor, your oasis away from the world. You won't let anything bother you. You won't let anything interrupt your peace. We all have families, we all have friends, we all have pets, things happen. But if any of those things intrude on your peace, you are not going to let them interrupt your peace. You are simply going to allow them to become part of your magical process. Embrace it and come right back into this moment. Sitting up tall and elegantly, nice flat back. Hands resting lightly on your knees, palms up to receive, palms down to ground. And let's just start paying attention to the quality of our breath now. The taller and straighter we sit up, obviously, the better our breaths are. So I'd like you to take a deep breath in, two, three, four. Let it go, two, three, four. In, two, three, four. Out, two, three, four. In. Two, three, four, out, two, three, four, in, two, three, four, out, two, three, four. Just keep it going. You don't need me to tell you how to breathe. But now that you've got a nice rhythm, try to maintain it. Every time you're in a pose and your body tells you, I can't do this, let me rephrase that. Every time your brain tells you, I can't do this, I want you to come back to the breath and see if you can't hold it for one more breath. Remember that your mind always gives up before your body does. And not everyone can do every pose. So when I ask you to do something like hold a plank and you simply cannot because your body just does not have the ability to sustain it in a safe way, which is all not being able to do something is, you'll drop your knees, but you'll continue to hold the pose, coming back to this breath as your pledge. Your source of strength, your reminder to yourself that you are here today to be your very, very best. And being your very, very best doesn't mean that you nail every single pose. It means that you do your best for every single pose and you make this practice your own. If everyone videoed themselves practicing today and you lined them all up, no two would look the same. And that's one of the most beautiful things about yoga is how you can make it your own. It's as unique and beautiful as you are. So one more big breath in. Sigh it out through your mouth. Seal your lips, let's cultivate that ujjayi breath. In through your nose and out through your nose. Get that breath really moving. And then make your way to tabletop, hands and knees. Fingers spread wide, knees under hips. Take the crown of your head forward, straighten out your back, keep the elbows hugged in, nice and safe. Inhale, belly drops, head and hips lift. Exhale, round and curl. Cat. Keep it going with your own breath. Keep it going. And the next time you come to cat, hold it there. Back arched, head hanging. Press through the fingers, rise up a little higher. Take the hips back, stretch it out. Stretch your arms, stretch your shoulders, stretch your spine. Come back to neutral. Take the right leg, swing it around to the right, and just send your right arm up to the sky. Exhale, bring that hand down. Inhale, take them both up. Exhale, take it to the right. Inhale, center. Exhale to the ground. Swing the right leg around to meet the left. Go ahead and drop those hips coming around in big circles. Dancing lion. We're going clockwise right now. Loosening up everything, working the wrists. Coming really far forward so they get a little bit of a nice stretch. Loosening up those hips. Keep it going with your breath. Bring it back to center. Come back to your tabletop. Straighten everything out. Make sure you're aligned again. Take the left leg up. Swing it around to the left. Left arm comes up. Left arm comes down. Both arms come up. Drop it to the left. Swing that left leg around, sorry. And let's take it to dancing lion, going in the opposite direction, counterclockwise this time. Again, working out the hips, working out everything. It's gonna feel different going in this direction. Good, it should. So do what feels good on this side. With it. Bring it back to center, back to your tabletop. When you're ready, tuck your toes, downward facing dog. And take a moment walking your dog. Inhale, forward plank. Exhale, down dog. Inhale, plank. Exhale, down dog. Inhale, plank. Exhale, drop the knees down, lower all the way to the ground. Stay here for a moment. Next, inhale, take it up to cobra. Take it back to downward facing dog. Let's put that all together now. Inhale, plank. Exhale, lower down. Inhale, up into cobra. Exhale, downward facing dog. Walk your hands back to your feet. Fold at the back of your mat. And let go here, just hang. Release with every exhale a little bit more. Bend your knees as much as you need to get a really good stretch here. Grab opposite elbows. Allow it to weigh you down, stretch you out. Release the hands, hang like a rag doll. Then we're gonna reverse swan dive all the way up, arms reach. Stay here, fingertips reaching for the sky. Stretch those fingers out, stretch the hands out, stretch your arms up, just get a nice stretch. Press through your feet, reach up even higher. Exhale, bring your hands to heart center. Bow your chin. Let's not forget to take a moment to be grateful for all that we have at this moment. For those of us practicing today, we have our safety, our health, and our freedom. The world is in so much need of loving kindness and healing right now. So let's send some of that out with our next breath. And then find Tadasana, standing mountain pose. Feet are hip width to shoulder width apart. They're pressing actively into the ground. Fingertips reaching for the earth. You are tall and proud. Hold it here. Close your eyes, turn inward. Shoulders come down and back. While you're just standing here, I want you to focus on the little toe of either foot, whichever one you favor. I want you to think about how that toe is working in conjunction with the rest of your body to hold you here. A little toe that you never think of unless you stub it on something or have to paint your toenails. But right now it is instrumental in keeping you here balanced. And that's how sometimes little insignificant parts of your life is suddenly so important when your balance is in question. And every time you see one of those little tiny bits of your life affecting everything around you, I want you to come back to the toe and remember that it all has to work together to keep you in balance. Look down at your toes. Pick them up, spread them nice and wide. Now drop them down again. Get that Ujjayi breath flowing. Inhale, take your arms up. Exhale, swan dive down. Inhale, lift and lengthen. Exhale, fold. Inhale, all the way up, arms reach. Exhale, stretch to the right. Inhale, center. Exhale, stretch to the left. Inhale, center. Heart press. Inhale, arms reach. Exhale, swan dive down. Inhale, lift and lengthen. Exhale, fold. Inhale, all the way up, arms reach. Exhale to the right. Inhale. Left. Inhale. Heart press. Inhale. Inhale up, exhale right, inhale center, exhale left, inhale up, exhale heart press, inhale it right back up, and exhale fold. Hang out here for just a moment. Walk your hands forward to a downward facing dog. Come to plank. Drop your knees for just a moment. Come to forearms. Come all the way down, actually. Fuck it, we're gonna go right to Sphinx. Come, forearms down, your elbows are right beneath your shoulders, your hands are spread nice and wide. Take your feet as wide apart as you want, and now press through the forearms, press through the hands. Lift your chest up and forward, crown of your head comes up, gaze is in front of you so you don't strain your neck. Slightly looking down. Don't be trying to look up. Face is in passive. Try to keep your lower body passive. Keep pressing through those hands, pressing through those arms. This is all upper body here. It's also a lot easier to do when you're not talking. Tuck your toes. Whoop, I missed it. And come up to a forearm plank. You can go ahead and interlace your fingers if you want. For 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Take it back to dolphin. Once again, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Take it back to dolphin. Drop your knees to the ground. Lower yourself all the way down. Take your arms down along your side. Turn your face the other direction and just relax here for a moment. Go ahead, flip it around the other way. Yeah. Bring your forehead back to center. Bring your hands right alongside your chest. Press up to cobra. Take it back to downward facing dog. Tippy toe jump or bunny hop to the top of the mat. Fold when you get there. Inhale, lift and lengthen. Exhale, fold. Plant your hands and use blocks if you have them and you like them. You're going to step your left foot back forward for lunge. Forgot the name of it. When you feel stable, you are on the ball of that left foot, but your heel is pulling for the ground for stability. When you feel stable, rise up. I don't look very stable at all. Reach up, up, foot pulls down, down. Open it to the left. Back to center, hands to the ground. Straighten that front knee. Go ahead, stretch that hamstring out. Left foot still stays up. down, step it back to downward facing dog. Hang out here for just a moment. Shake your hips back and forth, whatever makes you happy. And then tippy toe jumper, bend half to the top of your mat. Fold again. Inhale, lift and lengthen. Exhale, fold. Hands planted down. Step that right foot back. Setting up for lunge on this side. Rise up. Once you're up, hold it here. Now let's swing it up and to the right. Arms back up. Hands come down. Straighten that front knee as well as you can. Just hang over it, stretch your hamstring. This time I'm gonna ask you to step the right foot forward, fold at the top of your mat. Just hang for a moment. Bring your left foot to the outside of your right ankle or your right calf. Left hand, sorry, did I say left foot? Left hand to the outside of your right calf, right arm to the sky, you got it. That's marriage, knowing what the other person's saying even when they're not even speaking the same language. Go ahead, bring it down. When you're ready, you're gonna switch. Go ahead, come back to the top of your mat and fold. When you're ready, rise all the way up. Arms come all the way up. Bring your hands to heart center. I want you to pick up all of the toes on your right foot. Spread them big and wide. Drop them down. When you are ready, we're going to tree. When you're ready, inhale the left knee out in front. Exhale, step it back to 45 degrees. Square your hips, rise up, warrior one. Exhale, cactus arms. Inhale, take it up. Exhale, cactus arms. Inhale. Exhale. Take a little back bend here because they're fun. Inhale it up. Exhale, interlace your hands behind your back. Inhale your heart up. Exhale, come down. Humble warrior. This is going to be your exit breath, so I want you to rise up. You're gonna take your hands down in front, shift the weight to your right foot. Woo! Warrior three, or airplane. When we come down, we're gonna step that foot back for warrior two stance. Arms float out, one in front, one in back. Drop the shoulders. Focus on that right middle finger. Inhale, reverse warrior. Exhale, side angle. Inhale. Exhale. hold it here. Take whatever version of side angle makes you happiest today. We're gonna take it back to warrior two. Straighten the front knee. Take the right arm back. Take the left arm forward, flex the hand, stretch it out. Windmill down, frame the right hand. Step it back to downward facing dog, or move through a vinyasa if you really need to. Whichever option you've chosen, come to the top of your mat. Fold. Inhale, lift and lengthen. Exhale, fold. You can put your hands behind your calves, behind your knees, and just really pull the top half of your body down for a moment. Go ahead, release. Slowly rise up. Bring those hands right back to heart center. Pick up all of the toes on your left foot. Spread them wide. When you're ready, we're going to come to tree on this side. Inhale, take that right knee up in front of you. Exhale, take it back, warrior one. Once your feet feel set up, rise up. Exhale, cactus arms. This time they're coming forward though. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. In. Take it to a little back bend here. Inhale them up. Exhale, interlace them behind your back. Inhale that heart up to the sky. And exhale, humble warrior, left shoulder to left knee. Pivoting your torso to the right if you have to. Your humble warriors don't feel so humble. Try that pivot trick. Just hinge from your hips. Don't move your legs. Just take it an inch and you'll see how much further you can go into it. This is going to be your exit breath though. So on your exhale, rise back up. Warrior one. Take the hands out in front. Kick off. Woo! Warrior three. See, it's not my day, but hey, I held the tree. Who cares? When you are ready, in 3, 2, 1, we're gonna step it back to warrior two stance. Make sure your feet are properly aligned. Left arm in front, right arm in back. Gaze is on that left middle finger. Check the bend in the left knee. Also check and make sure it's aligned with your second toe. Shoulders come away from the ears. Inhale. Exhale, up and over, side angle. Inhale, reverse. Exhale. Inhale. Stretch it out. Stretch it from the tip of that middle finger all the way to the outside edge of that foot. Warrior two. Straighten the front knee. Left arm floats up and over. Right arm comes forward. Pushes. Hand is flexed. Wrist is flexed. Up, frame the left foot. Step it back to downward facing dog. Drop your knees to the ground, take a child's pose, or take a water break. You are practicing outside. It is warm in South Florida today. You know what, even if you take the water break, take the child's pose afterwards. Let's do it. And while you are here in your child's pose, third eye connected to the ground. I want you to feel all of that universal energy, just everybody's energy from the ground just coming up into you, filling you with love, wisdom. Maybe the energy to just carry on for a little bit longer. Ah, we're good. Just feel yourself surrender here. When you're ready, pull yourself back up into tabletop. Let's go ahead and send our right legs out behind us. Nice strong leg. Exhale, toes all the way to the ground. Inhale it up. Exhale it down, go slow. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale it up. Swing that foot all the way up and over the other one. Open the right arm, supported side plank. Roll carefully back to your tabletop. Go ahead, wiggle that tush back and forth to shake those hips out. Now when you're ready, we're gonna float that left leg out behind us. Exhale, toes all the way to the ground. Inhale it up. Exhale it down. Inhale, exhale, inhale up, swing that leg around, open the left arm, supported side plank, and of course take it further if you have a deeper conversion of the pose. Roll it back down to your tabletop, shake those hips out one more time. When you're ready, tuck those toes. Let's pop up, downward facing dog. This time I want everyone to tippy toe, even me, to the top of their mat. I'm bold. Inhale, lift and lengthen. Exhale, fold. Inhale, all the way up, arms reach. Bring your hands to heart center. Once again, make sure that your feet are as firmly grounded as they can be. If that involves lifting up your toes and putting them back down, do it. When you feel like your feet are as firmly rooted as you can, inhale, take your arms up. Exhale, sit back in your chair. Inhale up. Exhale down. Inhale. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale, hold it here. Inhale, reach forward. Exhale, swing the arms back and through. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale, back and through, hold it here. Come to your tiptoes. Inhale, drop the heels, reach all the way up. Step your feet to the outside edge of your mat. Arms reach up. As you exhale, I want to hear a loud whoosh, bend your knees. Inhale. Keep going. Keep it going. Move faster if you want. Inhale, arms reach. Exhale, hands to heart center. Hold it here. Connect with your breath again. Slow it down. So kriyas are generally part of kundalini yoga, which has to do with a lot of energy work. Sometimes it's nice to just make one or two kriyas into this practice just to get the heart rate going, just to get some of that energy moving. It was a toss between doing that or doing some rage yoga with you where we just screamed for a few minutes, because I think we all need that right now. So go ahead, take those arms up gently. And as you exhale, just fold over the right leg. Hands to the outside of the right ankle. Just let it go. Walk it around to the left ankle. Come to center. Just hold. When you're ready, we'll rise up slowly. Bring our feet back to about hip width to shoulder width apart. Find Tadasana once more. That's a good one. He's gonna earn his breakfast this morning. Inhale, take your arms up. Exhale, chair. Inhale, take your arms up. Exhale, swan dive down. Plant the hands, step the left foot back. Root it down at 45 degrees. Inhale, warrior one. Exhale, frame the right foot. Inhale, move through your vinyasa. So inhale, plank. Exhale, there you go. I'll meet everybody back at the top of their mat. Hold it. Inhale, lift and lengthen. Exhale, fold. Plant the hands, step the right foot back. Exhale, 45 degrees. Inhale, warrior one. Exhale, frame the left foot. Inhale, plank. Exhale, lower to the ground. Inhale. Exhale, downward facing dog. Float back to the top of your mat and fold. Inhale, lift and lengthen. Exhale, fold. Inhale, all the way up, arms reach. Exhale, chair. Inhale, up. Exhale, Tadasana. Take your hands all the way up. Come to your tiptoes. Keep reaching up. Just balance on your tiptoes. And bring your hands to heart center as you slowly start to come down into a toe stand. And when you're just about all the way down, let's push back up. Hands back up. Take it down. One more, we're gonna go back up. And then come back down. We're gonna hold it here this time. So if you want to practice toe stand, but if you would be happier in a yogi squat, you may go ahead and do that. Would you like to demonstrate your squat since mine is terrible? A block perfectly right under there. If I'm not sitting on blocks, it's not happening. So you're welcome to hang out here and just meditate. But if you have a crane or a crow that you are playing with and would like to practice, take this moment to do that. When you're done with that, I'm going to invite you to come comfortably to your tush without falling and cracking your skull open for those of you who are coming out of their squats. Bring the soles of your feet together. Press through those sits bones. You can move some of the extra padding out of the way if you want. And just rise up, hands on your ankles or on the ground. Close your eyes. Don't do anything else. Just rise up. Just keep pressing through those sits bones with a nice straight spine. That's it. Press down a little farther, sit up a little higher, and now hinging from your hips, come forward. When you get to the place where you can go no further, relax your shoulders, relax your neck. See if you have any more to give the pose now. See if you can deepen the stretch. Slowly come up. You're going to take the right leg out to the side as far as you can. Tuck the left foot all the way in as high as you can make it. Now, I can't because my left shoulder is still bum. And I want you to reach your left arm around behind your back and see if you can even find that left foot. If not, just tuck it comfortably into the right hip socket and just take the right hand over to the right foot in your twist. Two more breaths here. And slowly untangle that left arm and rise up. Let's bring the soles of our feet back together again, just to give ourselves a little reset. Just bow down to them for just a couple of seconds. And then when we're ready, we're gonna take that left leg open. Oh my goodness. We're going to tuck that right foot in as high as it goes. This time you're going to reach the right hand around. Maybe you just get to the hip socket. Maybe you have the flexibility to get all the way to that foot. Left arm's going to just touch the left toes. Stretch it out. Go ahead, untangle. Again, let's come back to center. And we're gonna come to our Baddha Konasana once more, bowing all the way down, relaxing into the stretch. Not trying to hold anything back this time, fully surrendering. Surrender a little more. Slowly rise up, bring the knees together, take it back till you're balanced on your tailbone. You can bring your hands behind, if there's a wet foot, you can bring your hands, I keep touching it, you bring your hands behind you if you want. We're going to do toe taps in boat. So inhale as the right toe touches, exhale as the left toe touches. So take them both up. Keep it going. After the next time your left toe comes down, hug it in, gently lower down to the ground. I am off my mat completely. Hug your knees into your chest. Give yourself a big old hug. Rock gently from side to side because it feels nice. Then drop your left foot to the ground, cross the right ankle over the left quad. Flex the right foot. Pick the left foot up off the ground, flex the left foot. And now hug it all in. Left foot comes to the ground, right foot joins it. It's just windshield wiper those knees a few times, moving with your breath. So inhale as your knees drop to the right. Exhale as they drop to the left. Remember, as long as you're moving with your breath, it's yoga. Come back to center after the left side. Next time you go to the left. And you are going to cross the left ankle over the right quad now. Flex the left foot. Pick the right foot up off the ground. Flex that foot. Hug it all in. Right foot comes to the ground, left foot follows it. Let's just windshield wiper them a few more times. And come to center, conscious resting pose, which is your feet just behind your glutes, arms down along your side. We are going to set up to do a series of bridges. So I want you to take your arms all the way up over your head, all the way down to the ground. As you exhale, you're going to lift your tush up and bring your hands all the way up and over. So inhale here. Exhale. Inhale, drop it lightly. Three more. Last one by my count. Hold it up in the bridge though. Hold it here. See if you can come up a little higher. Gently take it down. Hug your knees into your chest. Nice job. My microphone got buried. Sorry if you couldn't hear me then. Go ahead, grab the soles of your feet for happy baby. Start to slow your breathing down. And now, if you have a further expression of this pose, like legs up a wall or plow or shoulder stand, you may feel free to take those. Understand that if you are more comfortable with your knees just hugged into your chest or in happy baby, you are perfectly welcome to stay there. Any inversion will do. Give yourself about 3 to 5 more breaths before you start working your way back down to your mat, moving slowly and lovingly with your body. Once you're down, hug your knees back into your chest again. I should have mentioned that before you came all the way down. And go ahead and drop your knees to the right as you take your left arm out long to the left. Turning your gaze to the left, just relaxing into the stretch. More comfortable for you to straighten one of your legs to hold this stretch, then go ahead and do it. Your shoulders should remain flat on the ground. What's going on with your lower body is just to get the twisting motion in your torso. So if it's easier for you to twist with straight legs, with one leg straight, with a pillow between your knees, you do whatever you need to do to make this pose work for you. Bring it back up to center. And then go ahead and switch to the other side. Just like on the other side, do what you have to make this comfortable so your shoulders can remain on the ground. Start to bring it back to center, hugging your knees in one more time. And then slowly making your way down to the ground with the soles of your feet together for supine Baddha Konasana. Let your arms fall out to the sides, palms up. Relax. Take a deep, deep breath in. And as you exhale, feel all of the tension leaving your body. Inhale. Inhale. Exhale. Begin to make your way down to your favorite version of Shavasana. That's where we're headed. And I want you to just check in with your body. Do a scan from the tips of those toes all the way up to the top of your head. Is there anything that we didn't do that you needed? If so, take that stretch now. If not, I invite you to raise your arms up over your head. Stretch everything from the tips of your fingers to the tips of those toes. And then prepare for our final rest for Shavasana. Deep breath in. Exhale, feel your feet and your legs begin to relax. Big inhale. Exhale, feel your body and your chest relax. Let your belly go nice and big inhale. And as you exhale, soften your face. Take your tongue away from the roof of your mouth and let your eyes go soft. And now just relax. Deep, deep breath in. Sigh it out gently. Wiggle your toes. Wiggle your fingers. Take those arms up over your head one more time. Take a deep breath. Hug your knees into your chest. And roll over onto whichever side feels more suitable for you right now. Taking a moment to just appreciate that you got up on a Sunday during quarantine to do yoga. Taking a moment to appreciate this feeling of peace and serenity taking a moment to appreciate Richie for doing this for me week after week, because he's awesome. Take a moment once more to appreciate you for everything that you are. When you feel ready, rise up. Bring your hands to the center of your chest, bow your chin. We're going to seal this practice with one sacred om. Inhale. From our house to yours, happy Sunday. Namaste.
Namaste.
Now I must go drink some coffee. I hope you guys have a wonderful day. For anyone who is involved in my To Breathe Deep program, just a reminder that we do have a meeting today at 2 o'clock. If you would like the registration code, just private message me and I will get that right over to you. Thanks so much.